This is Robert Ian with GoldSeek.com Radio. Over the course of my adult life, the areas where I have had occasional significant challenges, those situations where I ultimately suspended my judgment, my analysis, my risk assessment for the alleged expertise of someone else because of their profession, or they came tagged with some other expertise, even though I had done my own work and reached a different conclusion. When I agreed to follow their line of reasoning, in retrospect, there was a part of me that just knew, in the moment, the course of action that was being followed would likely end in failure. And so it was. Over the course of my adult life, I've learned to listen to that little voice inside myself with more frequency, and as a result, it has rewarded me with greater clarity. One area that just doesn't pass the smell test is real estate. There are a number of markets I monitor closely around the country using Zillow.com. Zillow is great because it will send you automatic updates on the market condition of specific properties and search areas you are interested in. What is particularly interesting, and something I have noted in passing before, is that since mid-2015, real estate prices in certain markets have increased by 20% to as much as 40% in some markets. Ignore whatever happy talk you may hear about real estate, or chances are you may hear very little discussion at all, at least not the overt, in-your-face mania we heard in 2006, 2007, and 2008. But we are hearing national loan companies on the conservative radio talk shows throughout the day peddling their cash extraction strategies that, quote, might be right for you, as scenarios you should once again be considering. If your gut isn't telling you something is terribly wrong with this déjà vu, then your short-term recollection to the financial trauma of 2008 and 2009 has been compartmentalized or repressed. Because yes, it can happen again. If you watch all those homes sneaking onto the market right now, hoping to cash in on the artificially high inflation that has crept into home prices the past 2 years, your gut may be telling you that the first thing that could disappear in a market disruption is that 20-40% increase that has occurred over the past 2 years in some of these markets. And from there, all bets are off. Fake news may be the enemy of the state, but the enemy of the people is debt. Don't forget that for a minute. And until next time, this is Robert Ian with ConquerChange.com, reminding you to follow us on Twitter at ConquerChange. Thanks, Chris.
Okay, Robert, thanks for another excellent installment. Well, that wraps up this week's GoldSeek.com radio episode. For two new big guests, be sure to check out next week's show. Until we talk to you again, have a great week.